Happy Tuesday, everybody. We are so happy to be with you guys today. It's going to be another good day of SoTellUs Time, where we talk about everything that has to do with being an entrepreneur, helping businesses maneuver through all the ups and downs and twists that come along with building a business, whether that's home life, at work, so professionally or personally. We talk about it all. Today, we're going to be talking about, I feel like I'm a eToro, like, referral partner here. I got my eToro shirt on today. I recently invested in some cryptocurrency, and they sent me a swag bag, and it happens to all be on here, and I can see that it's all on camera right now. So, eToro, send me a referral. Send me a check for referring all these people. Today, we're going to be talking about some fun things. We're talking about the Babe Ruth approach. Now, the Babe Ruth approach. Everybody knows the Babe. He was awesome, right?
Yep.
He would hit that ball and just knock it out of the park.
Absolutely.
When he hit the ball.
Yes.
And that's the key. When he hit the ball. See, in business, a lot of these younger entrepreneurs and business owners that have not been doing this for as long as we have, right? The last 20 years. They are looking at their business from the Babe Ruth approach.
Yep.
They want to swing for the fences, which sounds really awesome, right? It sounds really cool. It sounds like a great idea. Swing big, win big, right? You don't hit home runs if you don't swing hard, right?
That's absolutely right.
All right. Well, the other thing is that people don't realize about the Babe is that he also held the most strikeouts.
Yeah, so he held the record for home runs for 39 years with 714 home runs, but he also held the record for strikeouts for 29 years with 1,330 strikeouts.
That's insane. And so that's the thing that people don't understand is they look on social media and they see these influencers and they see these, especially the problem is all the fake people out there that, you know, they rent a Lambo for the day and they rent a mansion and they do these promo videos and then they put them on social media and then people think they're actually something and they're really not and they make money doing that, right? They trick people, but they see those type of people. Plus they read all the articles, right? The two or three articles a day I get in my Facebook feed talking about so-and-so became a millionaire by doing this. So-and-so dropped out of college and is worth $1.3 billion now. And, you know, all this stuff. You read these articles. Well, the funny thing is, it's just like the Babe. It's right, Babe Ruth. For his 714 home runs, he had 1,330 strikeouts.
Yeah.
And those are actually phenomenal numbers.
Yeah, they are. They're actually great numbers.
So business owners, guess what? Entrepreneurs, your numbers are going to be way worse than that. For every person that you read that swung big and won big, right?
Yeah.
There was thousands who failed.
Right.
Failed, completely failed. And unlike baseball, where, you know, you made it to the majors and, you know, Babe Ruth for all these years hit all these home runs and still had all these strikeouts, more strikeouts, right?
Yep.
It's not like that in the entrepreneur world where he got to stay playing baseball. He got to keep playing baseball.
Yeah, he had a contract.
Whether
he struck out or hit the home run, he got to come to the game the next day and play again.
And get paid.
Right.
And in the entrepreneurial world, it's not like that. Most people who fail and strike out never get back up.
Nope.
Right? In fact, that's one thing that you can read in a lot of these people's success stories is these guys did swing big, fail, and then boom, they hit it large, right? Like Kentucky Fried Chicken Man, right? He was like, what, 85 before he invented Kentucky Fried Chicken?
Something like that, yeah.
Yeah, something like that. So, but most entrepreneurs don't do that. They can't do it. They won't do it. They peter out. So we want to talk about not taking the Babe Ruth approach today. We want to talk about the ways you can grow your business, the way that you can grow your business at a nice, consistent pace and have more success. And and let me put it this way, have a better shot of success, right?
Yep.
Okay, absolutely. So Troy, let's jump in.
Yeah, so let's just talk about that, because like Trevor said, you know, again, this isn't a pro, you're not a pro athlete with a contract guaranteed gonna make, you know, I think I was just reading an article on Luka Doncic, like if he hits what one goal or something like this year as far as like his numbers and winning like getting on one of the NBA All-Star teams or whatever,
yeah,
he's pretty much guaranteed like a 5-year $160 million contract.
Wow.
You know, right? So he's going to play. He'll play for the next 5 years once, yeah, he gets that contract, regardless of how he does.
Mm-hmm.
That's not how business is. You fail multiple times, most likely you're out of a business.
Yeah.
And that's just the case. Like if we look at startups, I was just reading some statistics. They said, it said that startups, 90% of new startups fail.
Wow.
So only 1 in 10 actually make it.
That's amazing.
And you might say, well, oh yeah, that's because, you know, most startups fail because they don't have any money. You know, they just don't have enough money in the beginning, and that's why they fail.
Yeah.
You know, mm-hmm. But here's another fact for you. 75% of venture-backed startups, so these are people that were just given money,
yep,
to start their business, 75% of them fail. So they didn't even have to earn it,
that's
right?
That's crazy.
They got the money, they started the business with, you know, could be $500,000, $1 million, $10 million, whatever it is, they still failed.
Yeah. Well, and I would like to know on the, you know, the 30%, 25% that didn't fail, how many of them had to go get round two and round three to keep going?
Yeah,
because really, if you're having to get round two and round three, you're failing,
yes,
right? And people don't realize that.
Yeah, I was reading another stat there that said only about 40% of startups ever get to profitability, where they actually make any money at all, like profit-wise.
That's crazy.
So, yeah, you're absolutely right. So it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter if you got a bunch of money. 3/4 of you are gonna, of them are gonna fail.
Yeah.
You know, and 90% of them are gonna fail, just like a regular startup.
Yeah.
So why do they fail? That's the question. And it was interesting, in this study I was reading, the number one reason was that there is no actual real market for their product or services.
Yeah.
So they swung big.
Mm-hmm.
They went out, they got the investor money, and they got up to the plate, and they swung with all their heart.
Yeah.
And they whiffed it.
Strikeout,
right?
Yep.
Because guess what? Nobody wanted their product or service.
Yeah.
You know? It's but crazy. They went big, and they're like, oh, you know, at least I went big. You know, I mean, yeah. And now you get to go home, right? So that's the number one reason. So, you know, just because you have money to market does not actually mean that anybody wants what you're selling.
Exactly.
So, you know, they're swinging for the fences instead of getting consistent success by getting on base. You know, if you think about like Babe Ruth, right?
Mm-hmm.
He didn't win those games by himself, right? By just hitting a home run and his one, that's just one run.
Yeah.
Right? That's just one. It was the fact that other people before him hit the ball and got on base, so that when he hit that one run, there was three other guys that are going to run in and, you know, get that home run. So he didn't win by himself, right? There was consistency
That's right.
With all of his teammates.
My kids, my boys love football. They play tackle football, and I was trying to teach them, and they got it now, but in their first few years, they just didn't want to listen to dad. And I told them, I said, listen, games aren't won by touchdowns.
Yeah.
Games are won by yards gained. And so they're always trying to go for the long pass, right? They were trying to run out and catch that ball and run and get a home, a touchdown. And, you know, the thing was, is again, in their thing, these are little kids, yeah, right? With little arms, and they can't throw that far. And, you know,
right,
I was teaching them, listen, games are won by yards. You watch these, I said, watch the pros. They're not always going for these long, sometimes, yeah, but what are they trying to do? They're trying to get that first down.
Yep.
So that they can do it again and do it again and do it again and then get in range of a touchdown, right? Or a kick or whatever, mm-hmm, they need to do, a field goal. So that's the thing, is they're, it's the same thing in business. Consistent success is way better. You have a better chance of winning with consistent success, getting your teammates on base and, yep, bringing them home, right? Than you do swinging for that home run and, you know, bases are loaded and you strike out.
Yeah, exactly. And that doesn't mean that you won't hit a home run sometime,
mm-hmm,
right?
All right.
But the consistency is what's going to get you there. So let's talk about it. How do you get consistency in your business? So we've got a couple of ways we're going to talk about today. First one is consistency, being consistent in your marketing.
Mm.
And this is a big problem we see all the time with businesses, right? You need to find the right marketing budget and you need to commit to it. Yep. I can't tell you how many times we see a business that's like, I'm going to spend a bunch of money on marketing. I'm going to cancel that marketing now. And then a couple of months later, they're like, oh my gosh, we have no new customers. We have no this. I need to do a bunch of marketing, right? And instead of just consistently doing marketing, creating a system of marketing that they can consistently count on, they just go up and down and up and down.
Yeah.
Right? The next person walks in the door and says, you should be doing this.
Oh my gosh.
And what do? They swing big. Yeah. They fail, you know, strike out right off the bat, and they quit.
Yeah, I was just reading another thing that said, the most expensive advice in the world is bad advice. Yes. Because they walk in the door, they give you bad advice, and then it costs you a ton of money.
Exactly.
Wasted.
Yep, so getting consistent in your marketing. The next thing is sales. Mm-hmm. Getting consistent in your sales, right? Creating a consistent way to generate new customers. And you might say, well, duh, everybody wants to just consistently get new customers,
yeah,
right? But we don't build systems and put marketing in place to consistently bring those customers in.
Right.
So a perfect example of that, again, is looking for that one and done marketing or sales strategy, you know, to get your customers. So it might be like, I'm going to, you know, one example would be, I'm going to go drop $40,000, you know, for this booth at this event. And I'm going to bring in, you know, if I can just get 1% of all the people that attend this conference,
yeah,
like that'll double my business. Right?
Yep.
No. What could you do with that $40,000 in consistent marketing?
Right, right.
You know, or it might be, I mean, I've seen the craziest stuff. Like I'm going to, you know, put my name on a race car, you know, and it's going to be on TV for, you know, 1 hour
yeah,
this year. Okay.
Is that really going to do anything for you? Is it going to build your business?
Exactly. No, that's not consistent, right? Right.
Well, and that's the other thing. We always are preaching avenues of revenue. And this is what we mean. You need to, if I can build this avenue of revenue, so meaning for people that don't fully get that, right? There are, and I actually have had some people, what do you mean avenue of revenue? What I mean by that is like you have these different marketing strategies, and if you can get this marketing strategy bringing in 5 new customers a month, and this yep, marketing strategy bringing in 3 new customers a month, and this brings in 5, and this brings in 10, you know, all of a sudden it adds up to that number that you want to be hitting. Instead of trying to find that one and done, I need 25 new customers this month, and how am I going to spend that money in one spot and make 25 new customers? That you might get it every yeah, once in a while, like we talked about, that home run, right?
Yeah,
you might get that touchdown every once in a while, that long pass, but more often you're going to hit your sales numbers and your goals if you have these littler ones that are consistent with what they produce.
Exactly.
You know,
all right, and the last one is customer service. And you might be like, what? Customer service? What do you mean consistent in customer service? Well, you got to remember, right? The cheapest customer
yeah,
is the one you already have.
Yeah.
Right? That's your cheapest way to revenue and more revenue. So if you can keep your customers by giving great customer service, that is one of the great ways to grow your business. So treat every customer like they are the most important customer. Mm-hmm. You know, I've seen this so many times when a business starts to grow, they start to bring on new customers, mm-hmm, they kind of forget about all of the customers they already have.
Yeah.
And they're so focused on the new customers. Oh, got to take care of these new customers. Got to take care of these new customers. Don't bother me, old customer. I don't have time for
don't
you.
Don't bother
right
me,
now.
Loyal customer. Yeah,
I got to take care of this guy over here who just gave me a dollar.
Yeah.
You know, I know you paid me $500, but this yeah, guy just gave me a dollar, right? So creating, you know, a way to, you know, treating your customer like they're the most important thing,
yeah,
right? Each customer. And then don't dismiss your customers when you're actually growing, because guess what? They're not going to stick around.
Yeah.
And when you're not growing, you're going to realize all your good customers left.
Yeah. I wish I still had them.
Yep. So creating that consistency in your customer service as well. All right. This is a pretty quick one. What about the homework, Trevor? What are we going to do for the homework?
Well,
this week?
Real easy. I think people can guess. We're going to evaluate our businesses this week, and we're going to find out where can we create some consistency in our business that will allow it to grow And I'm not talking by huge numbers,
yep.
right? I'm talking, hey, two or three new customers from this, two or three new customers from that, and being able to create some nice consistency. Because I'll tell you what, I mean, we do things that are big yeah, deals.
Absolutely.
We do things that bring in big numbers, webinars, events, but those aren't as consistent as the automation we've put in place.
Yeah.
So I can pretty much say that if I did nothing else this month, my sales team and my referral partners and my marketing is going to bring in this amount of customers.
Yes.
Okay, so I know that that's all set up and I'm good with that. And then when I go and do these events and webinars and things like that, then I'm like, oh man, now this is just like
bonus.
Oh yeah, it's like that strawberry. It's like having a piece of toast. And yeah, you got some butter on there, right? You got your butter. But when you put that homemade strawberry jam on, oh, yep. it's like homemade bread with butter and strawberry jam, right? Exactly. Just takes it to a whole nother level. I know, everybody's hungry. I'm hungry too, I know. All right, guys. Hey, thanks for being with us for another SoTellUs Time. We will catch you guys next week, every Tuesday, same time. We love you. We appreciate you. Please share. Get it out there to your friends, and we will see you next time.